we take the psalm in alternate verses. Psalm 112. Blessed is the man who fears the Lord, who delights greatly in his commandments. Wealth and riches within his heart, and his righteousness endures forever. The good man deals graciously and lends. He will guide his affairs with discretion. He will not be afraid of evil tidings. His heart is steadfast, trusting in the Lord. He has despised abroad, he has given to the poor. His righteousness endures forever. We will exalt him with honor.
Thank you. So when this corruptible has put on incorruption, and this mortal has put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, that is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O Hades, where is your victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. Thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you. ṣùgbọ́n àwa kò fẹ́ kí ẹ̀yin kí ó jẹ́ òkè ara ní ti àwọn tí ó ti sùn pé kí ẹ má bínú jẹ́ gẹ́gẹ́ bí àwọn ìyókù tí kò ní ìrètí nítorí bí àwa bá gbàgbọ́ pé jésù ti kú ó sì ti jí ìdí gẹ́gẹ́ bẹ́ẹ̀ ni ọlọ́run yóò mú àwọn tí ó sùn pẹ̀lú nínú jésù wà pẹ̀lú ara rẹ̀ nítorí èyí ni àwa ń wí fún ẹ̀yin nípa ọ̀rọ̀ olúwa pé àwa tí ó wà láyé tí a sì kú lẹ́yìn dé àtiwá olúwa bí ó ti wù kí ó rí kì yóò ṣáájú àwọn tí ó sùn nítorí olúwa ti ká ara rẹ̀ yóò sọ̀kalẹ̀ láti ọ̀run wá tí ohun tí a ríwó pẹ̀lú ohun olórí àwọn áńgẹ́lì àti pẹ̀lú ìpè ọlọ́run àwọn òkú nínú kristi ni yóò sì kàn jí ìrìn nígbà náà ni a ó sì gba àwa tí ó wà láyé tí ó sì kù lẹ́yìn sókè pẹ̀lú wọn sínú àwọn sọ́mọ̀ láti pàdé olúwa ní ojú ọ̀run bẹ́ẹ̀ ni àwa ó sì máa wà títí láé lọ́dọ̀ olúwa nítorí náà ẹ máa fi ọ̀rọ̀ wọ̀nyí tu ara yín nínú èyí ni ọ̀rọ̀ olúwa.
May I humbly request you to stand and surrender the night in àìgbàgbọ́ ìlà.
Oh. seated. at this point in time, we are going to call on testifiers to testify to the life and times of our dearly departed father, mentor, brother, Papa Venerable G.D.R. Please, when you come to the lectern, introduce yourself and tell us about your relationship with him. You may speak in Yoruba if you want. Four testifiers, two from the church, All Saints Church Jericho, one from the neighborhood, one a professional colleague, and we give a chance to the family to say a word. Five testifiers, four or five. 3 minutes, please. 3 minutes. 3 minutes each. Who is going to set the ball rolling? Yes, please. Mr. Jimmy Ojairi. The others, please.
My name is Jimmy Ojairi from All Saints Church, Jericho, Uganda. And I want to start by asking the question, who is the man that will not die? Psalm 89, verse 48. Who is that man that will not die? Father Ramona, already threatened my relationship, personal relationship that spans four generations on his 80th birthday. Four generations, I'm not going to go into details because of lack of time. But I'll just go into some of the qualities I think, and which we can pick and make use of in our own lifetime. In 1986 and 87, my son, my first son, Ushego Jahere, was voted the most valuable football player in Loyola College. And on the prize-giving day, he with an appointment I had in Lagos, I had to take him and his sister an appointment in Lagos, so he could not physically receive the cup, which was the award. Reverend Ramona knows me very well and could not fully believe the story of my son. So he said, let your father come and collect your prize. For about 4 weeks, I was still in Lagos. I could not spare a Monday to be in the battle. The fourth Monday, early in the morning, I went to the Loyola College. And he released the cup. The Republican side to the cup is that 3 months after receiving the cup, burglars came and carted away some of our goods, including my son never fully recovers from that loss. But the lesson there is simple, and it is to the principles of today. Here was a principal who wanted to follow up the domestic situation of his students. How many principals today would do that? Some don't even know their students, talk less of following their domestic situation. In preaching, I hold the first degree in English, and the word Saintspiration, I had it first from Venerable Daramala. I know what it means, and a lot of people know what it means till today. He had a patent for correct English. He wrote All Saints Church, and you put the apostrophe between the T and the S, you say it is wrong. It has to be after the S. That was his patent for the teachers. He was a teacher of all teachers. The Bible says, by his fruit we shall know them. I will only cite two examples. I think it is our own, the present governor of Ondo State. He was a student of Babada Ramona. The president of the Ofife, Oba Adeyeye, was a president, a student of Baba, and of course, Shebu Ojairi. I will not forget to mention that. Concerning visitation, Baba was a practical priest. He will go with the Bible under his shoulder, the diary under the other shoulder. He was an encyclopedia of people's birthday. In the morning, he would give you a phone call or come visit him physically. December 17 last year, I will not forget that day. In the church there, Baba was preaching the sermon, and there was I sitting by Mama. Baba, like a drink offering, was very poured out with the sacrifice of service to God and humanity. At the end of that service, he could hardly finish the prayer. That is service to God and humanity. I have a chat for the family. Of course, Mama, I don't have to talk about you because I noticed your fight courage. God, who is the husband of the husband, will be your husband now and hereafter in Jesus' name. When I was paying my tribute, I said, Papa's dead, just one minute more. Papa's dead, stress loss, and heaven's gain. I can only say it, the angelic host welcoming him to the wedding banquet. What of you, what of me? I believe there's a fellowship in heaven. And if you believe, just sing the chorus with me. I know
there is a
German church council. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Our protocols deal with absurd. Papa Ramola, where do we start? Papa Ramola was a minister in this church for 15 good years. First as assistant minister, then a substantive minister of the church. And I want to affirm, and I want to confirm that his tenure was a very, very peaceful one. Papa recorded so many achievements in this church. So many. I won't bog you down with all these achievements, because the incumbent minister of the church said this much yesterday at the night of tributes. My counterpart, Papa, was many, 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 many years ago. In fact, not only Papa, his wife and the children. Papa built relationships, real relationships, relationships based on love, mutual respect, and the fear of God. In fact, the fear of God, as we know, and keeping the commandments of God, is the only sense of man. That's our duty as man. So Papa feared God. When he retired as a minister of this church, he was an active member of the church. Active member. By the time I came on board as the chairman of the church council, he gave me full support
from time to time, as his usual, not minding if I mean, and my own prayer. Papa will say, Aburo, you are doing well. Please continue. You are doing well. We are proud of you. So that is Papa for you. He was a great encourager. Like people have said, Baba had a knack for record keeping. My wife's birthday, Baba will be the first to congratulate her. Ditto, my birthday. Now for all saints, church Jericho. Both the laity and the who attest to this that Papa was a powerful preacher. A very powerful preacher. This church would miss him. By the time he wants, you will love him. So you will love to be a priest. When he says, so, I quote. I end of it all, end of quote. That is a bad that I want for you. Talk of humility. The Bible was humility personified. Very humble. Whether old or young, male or female, Papa will give you that respect. Also, Sister Jericho is unique for one thing. And what is the uniqueness? All of us, we are members of the same family. Believe me, this is one of the things that had attracted so many people to this church. Because not only that, our motto is that they may be one, we practice it, we act it. In times of joy, our people are there. In times of sorrow, they are there. I'm not surprised the way people ran around when Papa went home. Like the last speaker said, December 17, believe me, that was a day I felt very, very sad when I saw Papa on the pulpit. Professor Nodego would be able to sat together. I said, what is wrong? The following day, I rushed there. Papa met me at home. He was coming from his physician. I said, Papa, what's the problem? You look frail. I said, Aburo, don't worry. My doctor has given me a... He said, Papa, are you sure? I said, yes. Okay. But deep down, I must confess, I was not convinced. Because my fear was that are we going to lose this man, this highly gifted man, this intellectual, this powerful preacher. Alas, 7 days after, he passed away. But we are consoled in the fact that Papa lived well. Papa, God and humanity. I'm very sure that Papa has found peace with his Creator. So, Mama, What can we say? You were a good supporter of Papa while here. Family was here at the church house. The door of that church house
was speaking through him of God to us, and January, the day of love, we are also chosen. So God is speaking to us expressly through his life. If you go deeper, 25th of December, 2 plus 5 is perfection. 14th of February, 4 plus 1 is 5. Grace. Perfect grace.
I stand here to give. I'm here to celebrate a man of value, a man of passion, a man of a man who lived a filled life. My dad was a man who, as the Bible says, fought a good fight, and he had won the race. And laid before him is a crown of glory. A godly man. You know, more often than not, people talk about the way of disposition outside in public. And daddy was a whole rounder. He was a godly man, he was a superman. There was nothing we needed that he did not provide. He was a true. I remember when I wanted to, when we were going. Okay. And usually I know that he has. I just felt that whatever is mine will come to me. You know, so, but I just got it in late 2017 to just ask him, Daddy, you know somebody in IMEC? And I approached the person. He gave me the number, we were able to talk and all. And down the road, long and short of it, we got a brief. The first time, you know, IMEC, we have been from other organizations and all, but I didn't like that. And that was a name, his name opened door for me in that regard. I truly want to thank God for that. I remember also last year, 5 years ago, when my wife at our workplace at NSIT, she needed to get a transfer from, you know, from Gragolada to the head office. One of Daddy's students at Loyola College was the MD, or rather he's still the MD. And just a phone call, if I can recall. And then days after that phone call, my wife was transferred. Daddy taught us how to be family men and women. He was a provider, he was a priest, he was a priest. Just as somebody said, quite a number of people have said in the last few days, he was an epitome of humility, kindness, and love. Lastly, I want to say a remark that Daddy was such a man that never wanted to inconvenience anybody. If you do good, if you do stuff for him, you know, he's not a man that I feel entitled. Oh, my children are doing what they're supposed to do. No, he's always a grateful man. You know, so I want to thank God for his life. Daddy, I'm going to miss you. Thank you.
With a round of applause, let us usher in the seeds of GD for the special rendition. Round of applause to the saints of Guinea as they take on the next item of the program.
Everything that we have, the only thing that we have, the only person that is personified in our lives. And that is why we want to sing this song, In Christ Alone. He's our hope, he's our rock, he's our refuge, he's everything. Christ in us, the hope of glory.
Thank you very much. God bless you. May the legacies of GD continues to live on and live in their hearts.
But these days we have even our students in theological colleges already scheming what they want to become in 6 years' time. And that's why many things are going wrong. When I came to serve God and he stood only for excellence, he never felt too old to do any job. He rendered service to God, whom he opted to serve. He was an Anglican to the core, an Anglican in whom is no guile. He loved singing church hymns, and particularly when hymns are sung with traditional tunes, you will see his face shining and singing with most sonorous vowels, because that is what he loved. Anglican hymns in traditional tunes. He hated aping other denominations. Remain an Anglican, be an Anglican, particularly when it comes to Anglican traditional worship, he wouldn't anybody go about and ape what is going on in other churches. An Anglican who there was no guy. He loves singing church hymns and canticles. He felt uncomfortable. As somebody said, when you stand before him and you speak grammar without sentence or verb agreement, or tense agreement, he will shake his head. And with correct pronunciation, if you speak without correct pronunciation, Veruda Abola would correct you. He stood for excellence all his life. He never preached or prepared sermon. Today we have people going to preach only with their tablet. What do you have? Tablet, or what do you call it?
iPad.
iPad. Yes, the Holy Spirit will do the rest. Not very good at all. He will prepare his sermon with accurate Bible references and with good quotations. God took him away like Enoch. As was said precisely on Christmas Day, after attending a cantata in the church, and he just left peacefully like that. I pray that God will comfort the wife, be her defender, and protect the children and grandchildren. The theme of my exhortation is, what is life? What is life? And I take my text from the Epistle of James, chapter 4, verse 14. James said, "For what is your life? It is even a vapor that appeareth for a little time and then vanishes away." The answer to the question, what is your life, may be answered from various perspectives, depending upon the person answering the question. To some people, they may say, asolaye, vanity, just like Solomon. After all his achievements and how he enjoyed life, came back and said, and I quote, "Then I looked at all the works that my hands wrought and all the labor that I had labored to do, and behold, all was vanity and vexation of spirit, and there was no profit under the sun. Somebody else may say, Bintilaye, very small, very little, transient, temporal. Another one may say, Ade Badaye, something you pursue without being able to overtake. Somebody else may say, Ugolaye, life is a battlefield. Someone else may say, Adichulaye, the mystery no one can unravel. Someone else may say, Aye Baduni, it is for merriment. And again, like Solomon, Ecclesiastes chapter 2, verse 24, and I quote, there is nothing better for a man than he should eat and drink, and that he should make his soul enjoy good labors, and make his soul enjoy good in his labors. This also I saw that it was from the hand of God. Someone else may say, for Ganaye is a marketplace. You can't go into Areni and go into Azov with the merchandise. Go back home. Others saw it as grass. Like in Psalm 103, verse 15. He says, as for man, his days are as grass. And in Isaiah 40, verse 6, it says, all flesh is grass, and all goodliness thereof is as the flower of the field. Psalm 103, verses 15 and 16 also says, life is as the flower of the field. For as the wind passes over it, and it is found. And of course, it's what the fall was. As for things that I put there, it says, for what is your life? It is even a vapor that appeared for a brief time and vanished. And of course, no, that as for things as his one and two says,
and show appreciation more
and love the people in our lives we've never loved before. If we treat each other with respect, and more often wear a smile, remembering that this special dash might only last a little while. So, when your eulogy is being read with your life's actions to rehearse, will you be proud of the things they say about how you spent your dash? End of quote. When Jesus came, however, he transformed the ideas about attitude towards life. Jesus came to the world and he did not bewail the brevity of life, but was more concerned about having quality life. He therefore condemned over anxiety and worries about life and its roots, like it is written in St. Luke's Gospel, chapter 12, verse 15, where it says, "Take heed and beware of covetousness." It's my own priest's hatred, for a man's life consisted not in the abundance of things which he possesses. He also considered this as long as what we have in Matthew chapter 6, verses 31 and 32. The primary concern of Jesus is his standard life, which is a life normally lived under God's rule and therefore a matter of moral and spiritual concern. Jesus saw life to be very precious and should not be destroyed, as himself is life. His focus was eternal life in Jesus. Eternal life was entering into personal encounter and relationship with God in Christ. This is when we admit our sin and we turn away from it. It is also in hearing and doing God's word. Jesus said, John chapter 8, verse 51. "Verily, verily, I say unto you, if a man keep my saying, he will never see death." Jesus Christ said, and this is eternal life, that they might know thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent. Eternal life, therefore, is not an extension of a person's miserable mortal life. Eternal life is God's life embodied in Christ, given to all believers, now as a guarantee that they will live forever. So Paul said in Romans chapter 6, verse 23, and I quote, "For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord." In eternal life, there is no death, no sickness, no enemy, no evil or sin, because Jesus has destroyed the power of sin and death and has conquered Satan. Then we can all live a life that counts. Let me quote here an anonymous writer, living a life that counts. And I quote, "Ready or not, someday life on earth will come to an end. There will be no more sunshine, no more minutes, no more sunrise. hours or days, all things you have collected, whether treasure without pleasure, money, will pass to someone else. Your wealth, your fame, your temporal powers will become irrelevant. And let me quote from what Solomon said before I continue the quotation. Ecclesiastes chapter 2, verses 18 and 19. Solomon said, "Yea, I hate all my labor, which I have taken under the sun, because I should leave it unto the man that shall be after me, and who knoweth whether he shall be a wise man or a fool. Yet shall he have rule over all my labor, wherein I have labored, and wherein I have shown myself wise under the sun. It did not matter," I continue with the quotation, "it did not matter what you owned or what you were owed, your grudges, resentments, frustrations, and endings will finally disappear. So too your hopes, vision, ambition, plans will expire. The wins and losses that once seemed important will fade away. It won't matter where you came from or what side of the chart you live at the end. It won't matter whether you are beautiful and brilliant. Even your gender and skin color will be irrelevant." So, what will matter is how long you will be remembered, and by who and for what. Even a life that counts does not happen by accident. It's not a matter of circumstance, but a choice. End of quote. Therefore, choose to live a life that counts. And remember, we come to this world only but once. As it is written in Hebrews chapter 9, verse 27, "And as it is appointed unto men once to die, but after this is judgment." End of quote. No opportunity for a second time. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. Whoever believes in him is not condemned, but whoever does not believe stands condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of God's one and only Son. John chapter 3, verses 17 and 18. And so I appeal to us here today. If you are here and you want to start a new life that counts, you are here today to make a decision, a new decision, I appeal to you to please bow your hearts. Only confess your sins. Because the Bible says, "But we are all as unclean things, and all our righteous are as filthy rags." Isaiah 64:6. So we are here today, we want to give your life to Christ. Please bow your heart and just tell Jesus that you are sorry for the sins you have committed. You have come here today to take a new life because you want to be with him in eternity. Do not be afraid and do not delay any longer. Put your trust and confidence in him alone, that he can save you. Put him in charge of all your plans and destiny, trusting in his words as reliable and relying on him to the power to change. Take hold of eternal life today. Take this precious gift and say with me, Kingdom Companion 51, give us, good God, thy grace is given. Indeed to live, indeed to die, before we offer pass to heaven, we may taste our immortality.
For all your children who have committed their lives unto you here today. Lord, begin a new thing in their lives.
Amen.
Let them know you anew.
Amen.
Strengthen their faith.
Amen.
Uphold them in your right hand of righteousness.
Amen.
And from henceforth, may they never fail you.
Amen.
And grant that they may gain eternal life.
Amen.
Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Please rise and you sing with me. Lord, sing, I will announce and you sing with me. Let me be with thee, where thou art. Let me be with thee, Lord, where thou art. Let me be with thee, let me be with thee, where thou art. Our lives unto you, because we know from you we come and unto you we shall return. We pray that at the last day we may have our place before your throne.
Amen.
And we are, and that at the end all of us will be fit for your kingdom.
Amen.
Grant this unto us, and we pray through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Now unto God, King Eternal, Immortal, Invisible, the Only Wise God, the honor and glory forever and ever.
Amen.
Still standing, we are going to take the next hymn.
Thank you. The Lord be with you.
Let us pray. Our Father and our God, once again we turn up thanks to you for who you are to us. Regarding Father to your Son Jesus Christ. Thank you, O Lord, for your greatest gift to mankind, your Son, who died for us upon the cross of Calvary. Accept our thanksgiving in Jesus' name. We want to thank you, Baba, for your servant, your Son, Papa G.P. Daramola, for his life, sir. The way and manner he went about doing things, both within the family and your church, accept our thanksgiving in the name of Jesus Christ. We have come to lift up the family up to you. Father, continue to be the father to the fatherless in the name of Jesus Christ. Continue to be husband to the widow in the name of Jesus Christ. We ask that your Holy Spirit, the comforter, you continue to strengthen this family in the name of Jesus Christ. Guide them, know that they will continue to do in Jesus' name. Don't doubt about it, they are going to miss him. But be there for them every moment in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord God, thank you for his service within your church. He's an exemplary man, no doubt about that one. And according to your word in Psalm 12 verse 1, the good ones are living. Father, raise men after the order of grandmother for us in the African church in the name of Jesus Christ. People who serve you tirelessly, serve you with all their totality, raise them for us in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray for your church, All Saints Church, Jericho. Father, continue to be with this congregation in the name of Jesus Christ. And for your church, the diocese of Ibadan, we ask the Lord, raise men like him unto us in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray for every one of us who are here today, that your Holy Spirit will teach us to number our days, to remember daily that one day will become to you. So we live in such a way that at the end of it all, we will not miss your eternity. Grant peace to us in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray for all the other programs, like for the final rites of Baba, be there for us in Jesus' name. Blessed be your name, O Lord. We pray with thanksgiving through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior.
Thank you.
I now call on Mrs. Ayo Ogunsemowo to give the vote of thanks.
Praise the Lord. On behalf of mom, my siblings, our spouses and children, I want to thank the Almighty God, our Maker, the author and the finisher of our life, our Lord who makes all things beautiful in its time, and who has purpose for everything that happens to our lives. You who has thought it perfect and pleasing to take Daddy home at this time, and who knows how to comfort us on this huge loss. I thank our fathers in the Lord, bishops, all the priests present who have left all to honor Daddy and us on this day. We also thank our friends, families, colleagues who have traveled all the way from various states and countries to honor Daddy and us on this day. I thank everyone that has supported and encouraged us with visits, phone calls and gifts since Daddy's passage to glory. It's been very difficult to process, but your love has tremendously helped us in more ways than we can ever imagine. I thank God for the gift of the family of Christ in All Saints Church. We are very, very grateful. My prayer is that the passage unto glory of Daddy will draw more lives to Christ.
Amen.
That is our prayer.
Amen.
That he's dead and that he's living indeed. I pray that God will teach all of us to number our days that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Daddy has left everything on earth to occupy his mansion in heaven, leaving us all to continue to work out our salvation with fear and trembling, knowing fully well that Christ has prepared a place for all of us. My sincere prayer is that we will all spend our eternity with Christ. We will meet him again. It seems eternity is far, but I know we will meet him again. God bless us all, and I thank you. Thank you. I want to respectfully ask all of us to please sit as we have prepared some refreshments for us so that it doesn't go to waste, that please will be served after the service. Thank you very much.
Thank you. At this point in time, we thank you all for coming, dearly beloved, as we have come to honor our father, grandfather, husband, fellow parishioner, Papa Gidi Damola. At this point in time, we acknowledge the presence of our fathers in the Lord, especially our diocesan and bishop, the Most Reverend Dr. J.O. Akinfenwa. Papa, we thank you for coming. We qualify the Most Reverend Fakwe, the Bishop of Remo Diocese, and the Archbishop of Lagos Province. Papa Reverend R.F. Okeremi, the retired Bishop of Ife East Anglican Diocese, we thank you for coming. The Right Reverend Dr. T.O.B. Fajemiroko, the retired Bishop of Ijesha North Anglican Diocese. The Right Reverend Dr. J.O.F. Olushola, the Diocesan of Ijesha Northeast Anglican Diocese. Papa, we thank you for coming. The Right Reverend Olubowale, the Bishop of Ekiti West Anglican Diocese, the Diocese of Papa Darabala, we thank you for coming. Ekiti Oke Anglican Diocese, that is the Bishop of Papa Darabala, we thank you for coming, sir. The Right Reverend Dr. C.O. Adagbada, the Bishop of Okeogun Anglican Diocese, the Provost of the Cathedral, the Very Reverend Dr. D.O. Olagbadu, we thank you for coming. We call you up in our midst, Mama C.O. Akinfenwa, Mama Ibadan. We thank you for coming, Mama. May the good Lord bless and keep you in Jesus' name. We have Mama Fajemi Rokun, Mama Okeremi, Mama Ogomosho, Mama Olushola. We thank you all for coming. May the good Lord bless you all in Jesus' name.
Dignitaries, brother dignitaries, we thank you. God bless and keep you in Jesus' name. We have in our midst the former minister of All Saints Church Jericho Reservations, Ibadan, in the person of very Reverend Oumi Oyuka. We thank you for coming. Equally, we have canons and priests of Ibadan Anglican Diocese and outside Ibadan too. We thank you all for coming. God bless you. Clergy-wise, you have all turned out in a very large number. May the good Lord bless and keep you in Jesus' name. The choir master, All Saints Church, thank you for coming. Oh, Mama Okeogun, Mama Adagwada, we thank you for coming. God bless you. Yes, I was talking about the choir master, All Saints Church, the person of Dr. Wole Adebiyi and Joshua Olale, and also our organist, Emeritus Professor Dele Falashe. The choir of All Saints Church, the leading the sidesmen and ladies of All Saints Church. God bless you for coming. The PA team led by Mr. Tosin Lesomi, thank you for coming. And tomorrow, there's going to be a line in state between 9 to 10. 8 to 10. Shalom Villa, number 21, Abayomi, Akimosa Crescent. 8 to 10 tomorrow. And the funeral proper is at 11 here in this church. May the good Lord bless you as you come. But I want to sound a note of warning. Let us be security conscious. There might be some unsaintly people amongst us. So make sure you keep your belongings secure. May the good Lord bless you in Jesus' name. We could have our helper priest, the Venerable Professor V.O. Adedipe, and Canon Professor E.B. Lucas. Thank you for coming, sir, and the Assistant Minister too, in the person of Reverend Dr. Kalu Ndukwe. With good Lord bless the church in Jesus' name. Please stand as we take the next hymn.
Yes, very precious and faithful Father, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you. For the lives and time of your servant, Father GB, dear mother. We thank you again for this service of song. I want to thank you for being the Alpha and the Omega. Thank you for my man, for the children, the grandchildren. Blessed be your name forever in the name of Jesus. We commit tomorrow the final rites unto you. Know that you will redeem tomorrow from all evil. All who will be coming from far and near, you will grant them journey mercies. Tomorrow again, you will show yourself great and mighty. Do for us all what only you can do, that we may see Christ before seeing death. Thank you, eternal Father. Blessed be your name forever. And so as you are precious in the precious eyes of our precious Lord, may the precious Lord preciously keep his precious eyes precious upon you. And the blessings of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, rest and abide with us now and evermore.
Thank you.